In this video, I am going to talk about an important polymer additive which is nucleating agent. Nucleating agents are very important for industrial point of view, as addition of nucleating agent in the polymer matrix reduces time required to cool down the product, which greatly increases production rate. Nucleating agents are particularly very important for semicrystalline thermoplastic polymers. They promote the crystallization of semicrystalline polymers by increasing rate of crystallization. Polymer properties such as mechanical, optical, and thermal properties greatly depend on degree of crystallinity, rate of crystallization, and size of the crystal. Hence, nucleating agents play an important role in modification of some of the vital properties of polymers. Nucleating agents can be in the form of dust particle or deliberately added foreign materials such as particles, tube, fiber, rod, sphere, flex, etc. Nucleating agents can be classified into two categories, inorganic and organic nucleating agents. Organic nucleating agents include natural fiber, crystals, carbon black, graphite, graphene, carbon nanotube, carbon nanofiber, etc. Whereas inorganic nucleating agents are inorganic salts, oxide, clay, silicates, glass fiber, talc, pos, calcium carbonate, etc. The nucleating agents are added in the polymer matrix via melt mixing, solution blending, or in situ polymerization. In melt mixing, polymer and nucleating agents are mixed together at higher temperature than melting point of the polymer. In solution blending, polymer is dissolved in solvent and nucleating agent is added. In in situ polymerization, polymer is synthesized from its monomer and during the polymerization reaction, nucleating agent is added. Addition of nucleating agents in the polymer matrix increases rate of crystallization by facilitating formation of crystals. Now let's try to understand how does nucleating agents work. To understand the role of nucleating agent in enhancing the rate of crystallization, first we need to know about polymer crystallization. In short, polymer crystallization occurs in two steps, nucleation and growth. Nucleation is a very crucial step. A nucleus doesn't form until unless it's thermodynamically favorable. Rate of crystallinity of a polymer depends on formation of nuclei. But when we add nucleating agents, we don't need to worry about nucleation step because nucleating agents work as pre-existing nuclei. Nucleating agent provides a surface to start the crystal growth. As a result of this, the polymer begins to crystallize at higher temperature. Since crystallization starts much earlier than the polymer melt crystallization, rate of crystallization increases in presence of nucleating agent. To have better understanding, let's analyze optical light images of polymer with and without nucleating agent. As we can see here, in case of non-nucleated polymer, that is polymer in pure form, there is no crystallization in melt state. As the melt cools down, crystallization begins. Whereas in case of nucleated sample, even in the melt state, nuclei are present in the form of nucleating agent. Therefore, in nucleated sample, crystallization starts much earlier than the non-nucleated sample. And also, number of pre-existing nuclei are much higher than the non-nucleated sample. Therefore, number of crystals in fully crystallized nucleated polymer sample is also high. Since most of the crystals starts to grow in the same time, their size is much smaller compared to non-nucleated sample. Now, the question is, how do we know if additive is acting as nucleating agent or not? So, DAC is the most common technique to identify nucleating behavior of additive. In DAC cooling scan of a polymer, start of crystallization process at higher temperature is an indication of nucleating behavior of additive added in the polymer matrix. So now we understood how does nucleating agent work. Let's try to understand effect of rate of crystallization and size of the crystallite on mechanical and optical properties of polymers. In general, crystallinity of polymer increases strength of polymer because crystalline structures are tough and hard and require high energy to break. As nucleating agents leads to formation of more number of crystals, these crystals act as entanglement point and thus lead to polymer deformation at higher energy. By incorporating special nucleating agents, we can change polymer crystal type. Some polymers crystallize in more than one crystal forms. This leads to different properties from the same polymer. For example, polypropylene has three well-known crystalline forms, alpha, beta, and gamma. As in XRD spectrum, we can see difference in crystalline structure of all three crystalline forms of polypropylene. So depending on the application requirement, we can use polymer with specific crystal type having desired properties. Nucleating agents are also used to enhance optical transparency, especially in case of semicrystalline polymers. Since semicrystalline polymers are opaque and translucent, crystals act as scattering center and therefore they scatter or reflect the light. That means they do not allow light to pass. For example, in case of pure polypropylene, crystals are so big that the final products are opaque. Therefore, to increase the transparency of the final product, nucleating agents are added in the polymer. That allows polymer to form smaller crystals. Since smaller crystals allow light to pass, thus the nucleating agents increases the optical clarity or transparency of the polymer. Nucleating agents are also known as clarifying agent when they are deliberately added in the polymer to increase the transparency. So, finally, we can summarize today's discussion that nucleating agents are foreign material that are present in polymer melt. Nucleating agents increase the rate of crystallization, improve mechanical and optical properties of polymers. But efficiency of nucleating agents depends on its particle size, morphology, chemical structure, and interfacial interaction with polymer matrix. Another important factor that influences efficiency of nucleating agents is dispersion of nucleating agent. Due to small size of many nucleating agents, they have a strong tendency to form big chunks, which limits their efficiency.